So as every tech YouTuber would say, Techtober has officially begun, which means we're about to drown under a bunch of new products. Actually, I'm preparing my body to embrace those launches because, oh man, the next few weeks, it's gonna be pretty hectic, to be honest. But let's kick things off with a bunch of news from Intel, which actually doesn't have anything to do with notebooks or ultrabooks. So that's good news, right? So which means we're finally gonna talk about desktop processors. All right, so honestly, guys, I've been pretty critical about Intel's Ice Lake and Comet Lake strategy for notebooks and ultrabooks. In fact, if you're interested in learning more about that mess, you can check it out right over here, or I'll leave links to two videos that I had to make for both Ice Lake and Comet Lake in the description down below if you're interested in learning more about their mess. I'm just gonna leave it right there. But today, we're gonna be talking about the new Cascade Lake X CPUs, their specs, and their lower prices. And in fact, it's gonna be a little bit of a different video because it's an interesting move from Intel, but also I have mixed feelings about it. So let's talk about that right after a quick message from our sponsor. The NMAX T50X air cooler now comes in this gorgeous white finish with an addressable RGB high pressure fan along with a patented air guide grill to increase airflow. The vortex differential fin design helps increase air convection around the heat pipes so that your CPU can stay nice and cool. Learn more in the description down below. Okay, so let's dive right into this and explain what Cascade Lake X actually is. These processors are meant to replace the 9000X and XC series, but they aren't completely new either. You see, they're still based off an updated 14 nanometer Skylake architecture, have the same number of threads, but higher clock speeds, and they use more PCI lanes. They still use the X299 motherboards, but most importantly, they're gonna cost a lot less money. Doesn't that sound weird? I mean, Intel, less money? Intel, less money? Isn't that more of an AMD thing? Yeah, but really, that's the basic stuff. But come on, Intel, it's time for a new desktop platform already. X299 has been around forever, and while sure, it does offer a ton of expansion options, but this whole thing was starting to show its age more than a year ago. Now we're starting to see it again, and I just think it's ridiculous. Let's tackle the lower prices too, because what we're actually seeing is a return of Intel's high-end desktop pricing from the Haswell E days, before it went crazy over the last few generations. Plus, let's be honest, if Intel or even AMD could sell their high-end CPUs for $2,000, they'd do it. Intel didn't want to lower their prices. No company would ever think of doing that. But what really happened here is better competition from AMD forced them to do this. Since Intel isn't able to increase core counts on 14 nanometer, some key Cascade Lake X processors will soon be competing against the $750 16-core Ryzen 3950X. Sure, it's been delayed until November, but that's when these new Intel CPUs will hit shelves too. And we can't forget that before its price went through the roof due to demand, the $500 3900X gave the 9920X a pretty good run for its money, even though it costs less than half as much. So what did Intel do? Well, let's actually take a look at their high-end desktop CPUs for a start. The first Skylake X processor was launched back in 2017, and it was priced at $2,000. But remember, this was back at a time before Intel had competition in the high-end desktop space. Then last year, the 9980XC was launched for the same price, featuring the same number of threads. And this caused an issue for Intel, a major issue in fact, because it almost felt like they were ignoring the competition because AMD was coming out with Threadripper CPUs. And with the new Ryzen processors and Threadripper 3 on the way, things needed to change, which is why we now have the Core i9 10980 or 10980XE. I don't know what you want to call it, but this is what we have. The new Cascade Lake X processor. It now features the same number of threads, but what's interesting is that it's now priced at $980. Now let's be honest here for a sec. $980 is still a lot of money, but what's really interesting is that the rest of the lineup are getting some major cuts too. You see, Intel really wants to avoid the $750 Ryzen 9 3950X I talked about, since there's no 16-core replacement for the 9960X. Instead, there's the 18-core 10980XE for $980 and the 14-core 10940X for $785. It'll be interesting to see how these compete on a price-to-performance level with the Ryzen chip, but the 10940X is sure a heck of a lot less than the $1,400 9940X was. It also looks like the 24-thread 10920X might be in for a huge fight, since the AMD 3900X is technically $190 less, and even the Threadripper 2 2920X can be found for less than $500 if you look really hard enough. Of course, core counts are only a small part of the performance story, but the Zen architecture is really competitive. The last CPU here is the 10900X, and it's supposed to be a bridge product between Intel's mainstream platform and the high-end desktop CPUs. It doesn't really compete with anything in AMD's current lineup either. What's pretty obvious is the $590 price tag, which was chosen very carefully so it wouldn't put pressure on the Core i9-9900K. I should also talk about the 72 PCI lanes that you saw in the last chart. That's a bit of a change since Intel's now using the same layout from their Xeon CPUs. So instead of having 44 lanes from the processor, Cascade Lake X will now have 48 direct PCI Gen 3 lanes, and those will primarily be used for GPUs, other adding cards, and the motherboard's M.2 storage or primary storage options, and then the other 24 lanes will be coming directly from the X299 chipset. The other change comes with clock speeds. I'm not going to go into the full details, but let's just say that the base frequencies remain the same as the 9000 series, while the max turbo rate gets a 300 megahertz boost across the board. When it comes to performance gains, there really isn't all that much here, even for professionals. But what did you expect from the third revision of an old architecture in the first place? I mean, Cascade Lake X will only offer about 7% more rendering performance than the 9000 series at the most. Intel did add support for their new deep learning boost algorithms, so that's one area which gets a huge speed increase. Honestly, Cascade Lake X seems to be proof that Intel has pushed 14 nanometer as far as possible. One thing we noticed is a big change away from marketing this platform to gamers, because a lot has changed in the last few years. You see, both AMD and Nvidia have pivoted their gaming GPUs away from dual and triple GPU support. So ecosystems like Z390 and X570 are usually a better choice for gamers these days. That being said, while X299 is still a pretty terrible fit for gamers, it still has a lot of potential for content creators, professionals, architects, people or folks who rely on those extra thread counts, lots of memory bandwidth, and of course expansion options, which is why Intel has Cascade Lake X and AMD with Threadripper. And that pretty much covers everything there is, at least until when these processors finally get released sometime later in October. But I do want to add some of my own thoughts too. You see, first thing's very obvious. Competition is a great thing, guys, and we have to give huge props to AMD for putting the pressure on Intel so that we could get these lower prices. But that can only get Intel so far, because there's some very serious concerns here too. Their flagship desktop lineup is using an old platform and an even older core. It's a power-hungry architecture, and that's a problem in a market that's becoming almost as concerned about efficiency as there are about rendering times. Cascade Lake X looks like another dead end too, and that's because it's a refresh of a refresh, which makes me wonder, Intel could have just lowered the prices on existing 9000 series processors and then focus on next-gen architecture. But I guess for existing X299 users, this could be good news because it's simply a drop in upgrade. But then again, it's pretty impossible to recommend someone to go out and buy a brand new Cascade Lake X system right now. So that's pretty much it, guys. That's for me. No ranting or raging in this video. In fact, I really wished if Intel did this a long time ago, but I want to know your thoughts about this. Do you think it's too late? In fact, are the new prices kind of like, are they attractive for you to make the switch over to Cascade Lake? For gamers, obviously not, because it's a pretty terrible choice. X299 looks outdated. I know, I have mixed feelings, but I really want to know your thoughts about this in the comments. I'm Ibo with Hardware Canucks. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out some relevant content over here. Subscribe and hit that notification button so that you don't miss out on a new video. I'm signing off, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one.